must be the place. Professor Oubier's house.
Looks pretty creepy.
I'd been away from Paris and hadn't seen Nico for nearly 6 months. I wanted to celebrate our reunion, but she had other plans. An appointment with an archaeologist. Something to do with a Mayan stone she came across while researching a story. The guy who answered the door didn't look much like an archaeologist to me. I had a bad feeling about this. I glanced over the books, vaguely hoping to find a copy of How to Deal with Poisonous Spiders While Tied to a Chair. No such luck. But I noticed one corner of the bookcase was supported by a loose block of wood. Maybe I'd been a little heavy-handed, but it was a question of survival. Of course, I was still tied to a chair in a burning house with no means of escape. Mighty bound, our hero was free. Now, I had to deal with that fire. In the drawer was a small decorated pot. Inside, I found a bottle of tequila. Normally, I didn't drink strong spirits, but today was far from normal.
Ew.
Disgusting.
Not only did the tequila burn like hell, I just managed to stop myself from swallowing the worm. I'd drunk enough of that. There was something short, fleshy, and gross on the carpet. It was the worm from the bottle of tequila. It was a stylish little canvas number containing a lipstick, a handwritten note, and a pair of nylon panties with a large love heart emblazoned across the front. It occurred to me that Nico's tastes must have really changed while I was away. Well, they could be useful. That dart was sharper than a mosquito's business end, but this didn't deter me from getting it anyway. I released the lock, something blew the doors open. The panties I'd found in Nico's bag were just what I needed to wrap around the hot cylinder. The cylinder gave out a faint hiss as the valve opened.
What?
Now I had one primed up and ready to use extinguisher. With a well-aimed squirt of the soda fountain, our unshakable hero saved the day. Now it was time to start looking for Nico. I wasn't going to burn myself on that red-hot doorknob, and it wasn't the time for subtlety. I'd found a piece of newspaper folded in two. It referred to a forthcoming eclipse of the sun. Unfortunately, it wouldn't be visible from Europe. The best place to view the eclipse would be Mexico. It was the newspaper clipping referring to the imminent eclipse. Wrapped inside it was another small piece of paper. It was a bank statement for Ubier's account from an automatic telling machine. The last five withdrawals were for large amounts, and all made in Marseille. The phone was no use to me. Apart from Nico, there was no one. It was Ubier's bank statement. I guess I had no business reading the note, but I figured it might give me a clue to what Nico was involved in. It was from André Labineau, the history student Nico had known at college. The letter was sentimental mush and revealed that the exotic lingerie, as he called it, was a gift from him. It gave his telephone number. Labineau figured himself as a rival for Nico's affections, but I couldn't believe that creep was in the running. Much as I disliked him, Labineau might be my only hope of finding Nico.
Hi, André?
Who is this?
It's George Stobart, Nico's boyfriend.
Don't you mean ex-boyfriend?
Look, I didn't call you just to pick a fight. I need to talk to you about Nico.
Can't you accept she's just not interested in you?
Listen, André, we need to talk. Nico's life depends on it.
Okay. You remember the cafe at Montfaucon?
Sure. André? You better show, you creep.
I felt an irrational urge to wipe my ear. The pot contained a key. The house key didn't fit this lock. I unlocked the door. I wasn't looking forward to meeting Labineau, but he was my only link with Nico. There was no sign of Labineau when I got to the cafe. I decided to order a coffee and wait for him. The guy who... Pardon me, but don't I know you?
Huh?
You were here the day I found the catacombs.
I was? Ah, yes. I remember you.
Yeah. Are you still in the police force?
No, not anymore. I'm a man of leisure. And what brings you back to Paris?
My girlfriend.
What it is to be young and in love. When you share a bottle of wine with me.
Hey, listen, I'd love to, but I need to keep a clear head.
So my company isn't good enough for you.
Why did you leave the police?
I was forced to retire. The golden handshake. Only in my case, it was more copper than gold.
How come?
I was made a scapegoat to cover up the department's inefficiencies.
Have you ever heard of a Professor Ubier?
No, monsieur. I don't recall the name.
Well, apparently he's an expert on Mayan art and history.
A little out of my field of experience, monsieur. If he'd been a serial killer or a sodomite, I might have been able to help.
Oh, garçon. He ignored me. I'm sure it was deliberate. What do you make of this news cutting?
Orphanage supplied fast food chain?
No, it's the article above that.
Oh! Total eclipse of the sun. Well, that's very dull in comparison. I don't know anything about eclipses.
Hey, you.
Quoi?
I'd like a cup of coffee, if you don't mind.
When I finish serving this gentleman.
Tell me what you make of this note.
From my years of experience, I gained a pretty good insight into handwriting. I'd say that note was written by a compulsive, obsessive type with an Oedipus complex.
Hey, you've got just about everything apart from the ponytail.
Un café.
Thanks. Do you know a guy called André Lobineau?
Oui, I know him. What of it?
Well, I'm supposed to meet him here. Did I miss him?
No, I have not seen him today.
That's all.
Thank you.
Well, well, this is a surprise, surely.
I wouldn't normally call you. But Nico's in trouble, André. Deep trouble. You have to help me find her.
What? What have you dragged her into this time?
It was you that recommended Professor Ubier as an expert on Mayan art. Now his butler has kidnapped her, and he tried to kill me.
Every time she gets involved with you, there is trouble. Walking out on her was the best thing you could do.
My father was dying, dammit. I had no choice.
Well, she soon recovered once she went back to her old friends.
Drop it, André. Right now, Nico's in danger, and we have to work together.
Well, how can I help?
Nico needed to speak to Ubier about a stone.
Oh, you mean this stone?
So that's what all the trouble's about.
Precisely. Nicole told me to guard it with my life.
Well, it's worth more than that, surely.
Oh, very funny.
What's funny is that your life really is on the line.
What are you talking about?
The stone is a Mayan artifact, dummy. And the guy who kidnapped Nico was from Central America. It was the stone they were after.
Oh my God, you mean I could be in danger too?
What can you tell me about this pot?
South or Central American, I'd say. I have a friend who'd be able to tell you more.
Where can I find this guy?
He owns a gallery on the left bank, the Glees Gallery.
What do you suppose the carving on the stone means?
I don't know. I haven't shown it to anyone.
Why don't you just give it to me?
I don't want your death on my conscience, Georges.
Where did Nico get the stone?
It was sent to her.
From where? Who?
I'm not sure I should tell you.
Oh, you should.
It was something to do with smuggling.
Does Ubier employ a guy from Central America?
Maybe. I don't know.
You've never been to his house? I thought you guys were pals.
Fellow academics, Georgie. It's not quite the same thing.
Why didn't Nico take the stone to Ubier?
I don't know. Perhaps she suspected something like this would happen.
If she's been hurt, Andre, I'll break every bone in your body.
No, that's typical of you. Do you think I don't care what happens to Nicole?
It occurred to me that slugs don't have bones to break. But I kept that thought to myself. Tell me about your friend Ubier.
He's more of a professional acquaintance than a friend.
I see. So you don't really know him at all?
No, I don't.
Take a look at this, Andre.
It's a bank statement?
Yeah. Professor Ubier's account. 5 large cash withdrawals in the space of 3 days. All from an automatic teller in Marseille. Suspicious, isn't it?
You're even more crazy than you were before.
See you later.
Goodbye, Georgie.
I've had enough of your games, Kala. Tell me what you've done with my stone.
I thought your business was simply smuggling cocaine, Karzak. Why are you so interested in that stone?
Either you tell me what I want to know, or Pablo here will make you talk.
Okay. Well, I figured someone at the university would be able to help. So I had a word with one of my girlfriends, and she told me her boyfriend was a lecturer. I sent the stone to the Department of Ethnology. You know, I figured it was South American, so... You're not buying this, are you?
That's enough! I don't have time to listen to your mindless prattle. We'll leave you to think it over. Come the morning, you'll be ready to talk.
Do you miss being a gendarme?
Yes, of course I do. When I wore that uniform, I commanded the respect. Not anymore.
I grabbed the flask and was struck by a powerful smell of absinthe, a highly potent and illegal alcoholic drink. Now I had another lead. I could either go back to Ubier's house or visit the Glees Gallery. The Glees Gallery had style and class, but very few customers. I splashed a little absinthe into the glass and hoped he wouldn't notice the change of color.
Did you put something in my drink?
Yeah, I did. Well, what do you think?
Well, it's certainly an improvement over Gliese's wine. In fact, I could grow to like it.
Allow me. Were those pots very valuable?
The pots are insured, but not the shelving. You've no idea how much that cost me. I hope to God UBA has plenty more of these pots at the docks. If not, I'm ruined. Go away.
There was nothing in the case but styrofoam packing, but pasted on the side was the remains of a label. Underneath the logo of a flying bird were the words Condor Transglobal Mars. The rest of the label was missing. It was beginning to make sense. Ubier had organized Nico's abduction. Ubier withdrew money from Marseille. Ubier was connected with Transglobal, who shipped their goods from a warehouse in Marseille. That's how the torn Transglobal label had once read. Marseille, not Mars. It wasn't much of a lead, but it was all I had. I set off immediately to catch the evening train. It was almost dawn when I arrived in Marseille. I traced Condor Transglobal to a desolate dockside.
As my dad used to say, I'm not into time, man.
Well, you're too early.
Oh, it doesn't matter.
The stick had a hook on one end. I figured it was a boat hook, for hooking boats. I just knew that boat hook would be useful for something. As for the bottle, even if I couldn't find a use for it, I'd cleaned up the dock a little. The bottle was half filled with water. Maybe it would cool the cone down enough to touch it. Now I could see into the pipe which formed the chimney. The bottle had blocked the chimney, and the hut was filling up with smoke. Someone had once told me a piece of coal brought you luck. Who was I to argue with irrational superstition? The packet was full of dog biscuits.
Here, boy. Have a nice crunchy biscuit.
I felt a slight twinge of conscience as I prepared to give the dog a dunking. It soon passed. As I'd expected, the dog could swim like a... well, like a dog. That did the trick. The fan clunked and shorted out as its blades were mashed by the boat hook.
Hey, you make any more noise, I break your arms.
That bully needed to be taught a lesson.
Garzak's already mad because we didn't get the stone. You give me any trouble, I'll tell him it was all your fault.
Karzak? That must be his boss.
Police, we want to talk to you about abduction, arson, and attempted murder.
Got a warrant?
Sure, I got a warrant. Open the door, I'll show you.
You wait.
That's got him scared and angry. The only interesting thing I found was a small brass key.
Whoa! Don't shoot!
The little guy had a blowpipe. That confirmed my suspicions about what had happened to Nico. I waited for him to shoot me, but it didn't happen. Instead, he seemed to want to tell me something. What? What do you want? He seemed excited, almost desperate. What did he want so bad? It was the metal... Hi. I'm not going to hurt you.
Cuaramonte.
Was that your name? Cuaramonte?
Cuaramonte.
His vocabulary seemed a little restricted. What does this key unlock?
Huh?
Hey, you're manacled. Who did this? That big thug? I'm gonna set you free, okay? Hey, come back here! The little guy had gone to ground amongst the stack of crates. Just in time. Interrupting the beam of light kept the doors from closing and stopped anyone from using the elevator. But what now? There. That would keep the doors from closing. Shaped scratch on the floor, as if a door had been opened in the nearby wall. My fingers traced the outline of a secret door in the wall. Then I found a small round stud, which was set flush to the surrounding wooden paneling. Just as I hoped, a secret room. Nico! Will you look at this? It was a small statue of a kneeling figure in an ornate headdress. The head was hideous, with huge, staring eyes set in a decomposing face.
Hey! Somebody's marketing Labano dolls!
There. How are you feeling?
Oh, thanks, Georges. How on earth did you find me?
I knew Ubier had been in Marseille. But never mind about me. How about you tell me exactly what's going on, starting with that Mayan stone?
I picked it up from one of Karzak's men in Paris. I was expecting a consignment of narcotics.
Drugs?
Yes. The proof I needed to expose Karzak's smuggling operation. I'd set it up to act as his courier, and once I had the proof, I planned to go straight to Inspector Moon. But instead of the dope I'd expected, they sent me that stone instead. And to find out more, I called Professor Oubillier, who invited me to his mansion. At least, I thought it was Oubillier.
I don't get it. If Karzak's business is drugs, why is he so desperate to get his hands on that stone?
Maybe it has some significance to the local people in Central America. It could be Karzak's means of getting them to work for him. Anyway, we've got to get out of here.
Nico, wait!
I decided to keep the masking tape. It was bound to be of some use to me. We can't use the elevator. If that thug Pablo's recovered, he'll be waiting for us.
We've got to do something. Where does that door lead to?
I'm not sure. Nothing happened. Hopefully, the tape would prevent those doors from closing and stop the Indian from being able to call the elevator. Silent prayer to whoever had discovered the power of hydraulics.
What on earth are you doing?
Trying to raise the statue so I can hook it to that pulley.
Is that really going to help us?
I like to keep myself occupied in times of stress. It was too heavy for me to move on my own. Could you give me a hand to push this statue?
What for?
This, my dear, is our passport to freedom.
If you say so, dear.
Push! Great teamwork.
Nice to be working with you again, Mr. Stobart.
Nico, I have a great idea.
Josh, where have you been?
Never mind that. Do you have the Mayan stone?
Maybe I have, but...
Don't argue, Andre. Give the stone to Josh.
Well, of course. If you say so, Nicole.
Thank you so much, Andre.
Georgie told me you'd been kidnapped, my dear. I'm glad to see he was mistaken.
Oh, but it was true. If it hadn't been for Georges, I wouldn't be here now.
That's not finished yet. Karzak's thugs will be back for that stone, you can bet. That little guy kept saying Coromonte. Perhaps the name is significant.
Coromonte? It's in Central America. That's where Ubier gets his artifacts.
That's all we needed to know. Come on, George.
Guaramonte, the traveler's rear entrance to Central America. Well, that's how it was translated in the brochure. We didn't know what we were looking for, but the offices of Condor Transglobal seemed a good place to start.
Hey, it's market day. I don't see any cabs. Let's ask someone how to get to Guaramonte City.
Okay. Keep your eyes peeled for any sign of Condor Transglobal.
Mrs. Henderson. Boy, this is some coincidence, huh?
When you've been married to a fruitcake like Dwayne as long as I have, you stop believing in coincidence.
I'd met Pearl and Dwayne on the other side of the globe in Syria. He was an army veteran who suspected he was working for the CIA, but wasn't sure. She was less obviously deranged.
Catch you later, Pearl.
It was Pearl's husband, Dwayne.
Hey, Mr. Henderson. Good to see you again.
Do I know you, son?
George Stobart, remember? In Syria? I sold you a statue.
I remember that. Pearl was mighty vexed when the paint came off.
Look, I'm sorry. I'll give you back the $50.
No, no, you suckered me fair and square.
Did you drive all the way down here?
Hell no. Pearl did the driving while I followed the maps. The way she handled the wheel, you'd think she'd been trucking half her life.
Why did you bring a huge truck like that?
George, I'm on a top secret classified mission for Uncle Sam. This truck is a rolling bomb. 400 pounds of nitrate fertilizer with a plastique initiator. They'll hear the bang in China. Gee, I'm really looking forward to this.
Do you know anything about a shipping company called Condor Transglobal?
Sure I do. You have to get up pretty early to catch Dwayne with his pants down.
What? You beat me to it?
Condor Transglobal is all wound up. Seems like my investigations scared them off.
The cell was vacant. There was a forlorn-looking guy asleep on the floor of the jail. He wore the same clothes as the band in the marketplace.
Hey, wake up!
He didn't hear me.
Hey, Nico!
I have done just as I have been instructed, Professor. With the mine closed down, there'll be no one around to observe your excavation.
Ah, I have visitors.
Just remember what I told you, General. There's really no need to make a martyr out of that man.
I'm sorry to keep you waiting, Senor. Welcome to Guaramonte.
Thanks. My name's George Stobart from California.
But what is this? An angel come down to Earth.
Nicole Collard. Enchanté, mon général.
Pardon me, senorita, but I couldn't help myself.
Look, we'd like to ask you a few questions.
You've come to the right place, senor. Tourist information. General Graciento, at your service.
was the guy you were talking to when we arrived?
Professor Ubier, a visitor, senor, like yourselves.
Did you say Ubier?
Si, senor. Professor Ubier, a French archaeologist.
What's Ubier doing in Quaramonte?
Researching our rich and glorious past, senor. The professor is planning an expedition to some Mayan ruins. He came to see me to get an excavation permit.
I'll be back.
Señor, leave that chart alone.
Did you notice that chart on the police station wall?
Yes, it looked like a map to me, but I couldn't make out the details.
Whatever it was, the general didn't want us to see it. Professor Ubier?
Yes? Who are you?
My name is Stobart. George Stobart. What do you know about my girlfriend's abduction?
I don't know what you're talking about.
She was invited to your mansion in Paris.
Not by me, she wasn't. I haven't been home for nearly 7 months.
What are you doing in Claramonte, Professor?
Seeking Mayan artifacts. Central American history has been my life's work.
Do you see this label?
Yes. It refers to a company named Condor. What of it?
I traced that company here, to Quaramonte. Do you know where I can find the offices of Condor Transglobal?
The company no longer exists. They went bankrupt recently.
I have proof that you are directly involved with Condor.
I used them as shippers to transport artifacts to a gallery in Paris. Beyond that, I have no connection with the company, which, as I said, no longer exists.
Can you tell me anything about this stone?
Where did you get that?
That's my business.
How much do you want for it?
It's not for sale. Do you know anything about this eclipse, Professor?
Of course. It's not the reason I'm here in Quaramonte, but I'm looking forward to seeing it all the same.
What's your interest in the eclipse, Professor?
Oh, it's purely a layman's curiosity. History's my subject, not astronomy. But I've been fascinated by the movements of the heavenly bodies since I was a child. I wouldn't miss a total eclipse for the world.
Does the eclipse have some special significance for you?
For me? No. For the ancient Mayans, it marked the end of the Fifth Age.
Perhaps we should be celebrating.
Ah, no. The end of each age heralds destruction on a global scale. The Fifth is the final age, ending in the total destruction of the Earth.
Does the name Karzak mean anything to you?
Yes, I know him. In fact, if it wasn't for Karzak, I wouldn't be here.
What?
He's financing my expedition.
Have you ever employed a Central American butler or servant?
I've never employed any kind of servant, monsieur.
Hey, cheer up, guys. What's with the long faces?
Our pipe player has been arrested and thrown in jail.
Poor Miguel. He never broke the law in his life.
Why don't you try playing a tune to cheer yourselves up?
No. We should be looking for real jobs.
We could earn 10 times as much down the mines. My cousin Ramirez was earning 8 pesos an hour.
Before he lost his legs in the accident.
Tell me about the accident at the mine.
There was an explosion at Teocalcan. 30 miners were buried alive.
They got some of them out, though.
Two of them, including your cousin, and they left half of him behind.
Why was Miguel put in jail?
For playing folk music.
What?
It's true, senor. He insisted on playing traditional Guaramonte music, even though it's illegal.
Take a look at the design on this label.
I have seen that before.
Where?
There was a ship flying a flag just like that.
When did you see this ship?
3 months ago. It was here, at the docks.
What was the ship with the Condor flag carrying?
I don't know, senor. We weren't allowed near the docks.
That's right. Usually we meet the ships when they tie up.
We play to the tourists.
Well, when the Condor ship came in, we were told to go away.
What was that?
It's a lump of lucky coal.
Coal?
I would have preferred chocolate. Any flavor, so long as it hasn't got marzipan in it. God, I hate marzipan.
You can talk. I mean, you're a talking goat.
Keep your voice down. This is between you and me, right?
Well, I guess so.
Now, I mean it. You tell anyone you've spoken to me, and you'll be cursed.
Hola, señora.
Hi. We were wondering.
I was talking to the lady, Chico.
Hi, my name is Nicole Collard.
Concha García. How can I help you, sister?
The corporation I represent is considering a major investment in Guaramonte. Your advice, as the head of an obviously successful concern, is precisely what I'm after. My assistant, Mr. Stobart, has a few questions he'd like to ask you.
Can you tell me about the accident at the mine?
Accident? It was sabotage. Somebody wanted my mine closed down for good.
Do you have any evidence that the mine was sabotaged?
Not yet, but I'll get to the bottom of it. There'd been trouble at that mine for several months. The workforce was getting smaller every day. Someone had started a rumor among the men that the mine was cursed. Now the entire operation has been closed down.
Where's the site of the mine?
Several days upriver at a remote area known as Teoculcan.
Do you know Professor Ubié?
Yes. I understand he is about to embark on an archaeological expedition. He hired some equipment from me earlier today.
I overheard him talking to the general. I think they're working together.
What? If I'd known that, I wouldn't have hired out the equipment. Now, why would the general be interested in an archaeologist?
Do you recognize the icon on this label?
Condor Transglobal.
Did the company operate here in Guaramonte?
Yes, they ran an old container ship, the Mayan Princess.
Have you heard about the forthcoming eclipse?
I don't take much interest in things like that. One of the boys might know about it.
Do you know who owned Condor Transglobal?
I have no idea. Keep out of there. That's where the explosives are stored.
Thank you.
Did you find any evidence of Condor's drug smuggling operations?
Drugs? Hell no! Condor was a cover for the illegal export of Mayan artifacts.
Did you know that traditional music is illegal in Caramonte?
Is that so? Seems reasonable to me.
No, really. The leader of the band in the square has been imprisoned just because of the music he played.
I don't know who you've been talking to, but that fella, Miguel, he's an agitator.
What's the real reason the musician was imprisoned?
Handed out subversive literature at the mines. That so-called general was waiting for Miguel when he got back into town. Marched him off to jail at gunpoint on a charge of inciting a riot.
Is Miguel the reason you're here?
Pretty smart, George. I was supposed to make contact with him. By the time I found him, though, he was in jail. I've been trying to figure out a way to get him out since then.
Sounds good to me. Count me in.
Good man, George. All I need is a detonator.
How come you brought a truckload of explosives but no detonator?
Call me old-fashioned, but I say packing trunks is woman's work. I left the packing to Pearl, and I can't find a darn thing. Just hope she remembered to bring my denture polish. I'd sure hate to arrive back in the States with tar on my teeth.
So who was behind Condor Transglobal?
It was registered in the name of Edan.
Did you get the guy?
I don't think he ever existed. Edan backwards spells Nady, Spanish for nobody.
Hey, Nico!
Do you have a map of Caramonte?
A map? I'm sorry, senor, but I don't.
What about the one on the wall?
Ah, that is an archaeological survey map, senor. Not suitable for tourists.
Do you know anything about the forthcoming eclipse, General?
Such things do not interest me, senor.
Take a look at this label.
Si, senor. Condor Transglobal.
Can you tell me where to find their offices?
No, senor. I never heard of them, and neither did Ronaldo.
The lady at the mining company told us a ship belonging to Condor was here recently.
Conchita Garcia is crazy. If there had been a ship, do you think I wouldn't have noticed?
I hear there was an accident at the mine a few months ago.
That's correct.
A lot of men killed, weren't there?
A few.
30?
Barely 1% of the working population.
Are you sure you never heard of Condor?
Oh, yes.
The company is registered here, in Caramonte City.
You are mistaken, senorita.
The musicians out in the square say that a ship flying the Condor flag was berthed here.
They are simple peasants. They will go along with anything you say in the hopes of parting you from your money.
I believe Condor is run by a man named Karzak.
Wrong again, senor. Karzak has nothing to do with anything called whoever he is.
Do you keep a record of companies registered in Caramonte?
Of course, senorita. Unfortunately, all the records were destroyed by a flash flood.
Is it true there's a restriction on music in Caramonte?
Yes, there is. An emergency measure introduced by Nuestra Senora.
Folk music is a link with the past for some of these people. Take away their musical roots and what have they got left?
Easy listening.
You think easy listening could replace a musical heritage hundreds of years old?
Why not? It happened in your country.
I'll be back.
Thank you.
came on a little strong with the general.
I was merely flattering his ego, Georges. Every man has his Achilles heel.
Maybe, but that guy's weakness isn't in his foot.
That man we saw talking to the general was Aubier. Didn't you recognize him?
I never met him, remember? The guy I called in Paris claimed to be Aubier, but he sounded nothing like the man in the police station. Maybe the professor really is innocent.
Nah, it's too much of a coincidence that he's here in Quaramonte.
Take a look at this.
An eclipse of the sun. Why the sudden interest in astronomy?
I found the cutting in Aubier's house.
Apparently, it's only visible from Central America.
Take a look at this news cutting, Pearl.
You'll have to read it to me, George. I left my specs in a gay bar in Santa Barbara.
Well, it's about an eclipse of the sun, which is due to occur in a few weeks' time.
You'd think the government would warn us about these kind of things.
It's not dangerous or anything. Apparently, the best place to view the eclipse is right here in Quaramonte.
Oh, my.
She didn't appear to be the slightest bit interested.
Catch you later, Pearl.
Do you have any kind of detonating device in stock?
Sure. They're kept in that cupboard.
I don't suppose you have one spare.
I can't simply give you a device like that, no, without a damn good reason.
The general has a chart in his office, which he was discussing with Aubier.
Perhaps that chart will tell us where they're heading.
Maybe, but I can't get anywhere near it while the general and his sidekick are there. Distract the general while I took a look at that chart?
You're kidding. Did you see the way he was leering at me?
Yeah. You'd make a great snake charmer. Come on. 5 minutes is all I need.
Well, maybe. But it's your hair-brained scheme. You do the talking.
My girlfriend has a favor she wants to ask you, General.
For you, my dear. Anything.
I've changed my mind.
Oh, no, you haven't. She's embarrassed about asking you for an interview, General.
An interview? With me? Fabuloso!
Well, I want to write a story about you.
You hear that, Ronaldo? An exclusive glossy spread about your beloved general.
Si, Signor General.
Look after things here. I'm going back to my apartment and I don't want to be disturbed.
I'll get you for this, Georges Tobar.
Don't worry. If you're gone for more than a couple of hours, I'll come and get you.
A couple of hours?
No, senor. The general said nobody must see that chart.
He won't know unless you tell him.
You don't know him, senor. He will worm it out of me as easily as he de-waxes his ear.
Okay.
I'd have to get rid of him.
Hi, I'm George Stobart.
Hello, senor. How can I help you?
Do you know anything about this eclipse?
No, senor. El General keeps me in the dark about most things.
I'd like to visit your prisoner.
Condemned prisoners aren't allowed visitors.
Condemned?
To death. He is to be executed. Knowing my luck, I will probably have to shoot him myself.
Amnesty International is going to hear about this. I thought Miguel was arrested for playing the wrong kind of music.
Si, senor, he was.
And that carries the death penalty?
No. You think we're crazy? While being questioned, he confessed to being an anti-government agent.
So long. What brings you to Cuaramonte, Pearl?
What takes me just about anywheres. The market.
You drove 2,000 miles to go shopping?
Shopping is my role in the economy of the great design, George.
I hear you drove all the way to Cuaramonte. In a truck.
That's right. You would not believe the state of some of those roads. Makes me downright sad to think there's still some places you can't reach in an automobile. In this day and age, you'd think there'd be decent highways just about anywhere folk choose to go.
Catch you later, Pearl. Are you still working for... you know who?
You know I can't talk about my work, George. That's between me and Uncle Sam.
Do you think the general was involved with Condor?
Hell no. And if he's a general, I'm a Buddhist. No, that fella's just a mouthpiece for the real power in Cuaramonte.
Does the name Karzak mean anything to you?
Sounds like a comic book villain to me, son.
He's the man behind Condor, and the rat who kidnapped Nico.
You know, the first time I met you, I was deeply impressed with your naive simplicity. I said to Pearl, if we ever had kids, I would have wanted a boy like George. But I underestimated you, son.
I spoke to Pearl earlier.
Yeah? Did she mention that we had a kind of falling out?
No, she didn't.
Well, we did. She ain't speaking to me.
Why isn't Pearl speaking to you?
She got it into her head to go visit some ruins. I'd take her if it wasn't for two things.
What?
I don't wanna, and I ain't gonna.
Why aren't you speaking to Dwayne?
Because he's an old spoilsport sourpuss. I want to visit one of those old pyramid places, but Dwayne says he has to stay in town.
Right. And you don't want to go on your own?
Well, there's no point in going to the pyramid if there's no one around to take my picture.
Catch you later, Pearl. Are there any ancient pyramids near Cuaramonte?
Si, senor. But it's not very impressive. It's in ruins.
That's perfect. Would you take my friend to the ruins now the general's gone?
I'd be honored, senor.
Thanks. I'll go get her. I've made the arrangements for your visit to the temple, Pearl.
Oh, that's just great, George. Why don't you come too, honey?
I'd love to, but right now I have to save the world.
Listen, sweetie. I'm looking for an official guide to take me to the old pyramid.
For a lovely lady, I would go to the ends of the earth. For you, I will go as far as the pyramid and back. But what about your husband?
What he doesn't know won't hurt him. Let's go, Beanpole.
As Poole and Rinaldo set out for the ruined pyramid, I prepared to search the police station. It looked like a geological survey map showing the land to the southeast of Cuaramonte City. About 60 miles inland and upstream was an area marked Teoculcan.
I got a good look at that chart in the police station. It's a map of Cuaramonte.
Does it tell us where Ubier is heading?
Yeah, a place called Teoculcan.
That's the site of the mine. I wonder why they're being so secretive about Ubier's plans. One thing's for sure. If the general's involved, they're up to no good. I'd like to talk to that musician we get. Take the detonator and get him out of that jail.
Here is the detonator, Dwayne.
Keep your voice down, George. You want everyone to know.
You'd best go and warn Miguel that the U.S. Cavalry's on the way.
Okay.
I couldn't reach the noose.
Hey, Miguel!
What is it? What is happening?
We're getting out of here.
Who's we? They've sent the Delta Force?
Nope.
The Impossible Missions Force?
Don't make me sick. Much better.
Who then?
A retired greetings card salesman from Ohio.
I'm doomed.
You're not the only one.
I should have known you'd be trouble the moment I saw you.
Look, I can explain everything.
Get in that cell, now.
And what if I refuse?
He'll shoot you.
Okay, here I am,
going quietly into the cell.
Very wise, North Americano scum.
One of the reasons I hate guns so much is the way they make people so damned impolite.
I hope you're enjoying your vacation, Signor Stobart.
Go polish your weapon, Rinaldo.
This was part of your plan, right?
Well, in a manner of speaking, no.
I was all out of ideas. It was up to Nico now.
So, here we are.
You've changed.
I thought I would slip into something more comfortable.
The stench of cheap cologne rolled over me like tear gas.
So, what do you want to know about me? Ask and I will answer. I will deny you nothing.
I am a very giving person.
How nice for your friends.
Your eyes are glittering like stars.
His damn cologne was making my eyes water. I was running out of sofa.
As spirited as you are beautiful, I admire that.
As long as he admired it from afar. I didn't want the picture. I didn't want to watch a lot of tawdry soap operas. On close inspection, I noticed that the swordfish was peppered with machine gun bullet holes. The general was a real sportsman, and no mistake. I didn't want the lava lamp. The tiger was beyond help. I love your TV.
Oh, yeah. Cool, no?
Oh, boy. Female mud wrestling.
Who's the guy with the hat and the fat cigar?
My mother.
That's an impressive hi-fi system, General.
Would you care to hear some music?
No.
Oh, it's no bother. I don't even have to get some. Oh.
Is that a lava lamp?
Sure. It's more impressive in the dark. I'll close the blinds.
No, no, don't do that. Not on such a beautiful day.
Mom!
What is going on here?
Nothing, Mom. I was...
I'm in uniform. And when I'm in uniform, it's...
Madame la Presidente, sorry, Madame la Presidente.
Now, what is going on here?
Nothing, Madame la Presidente. I was just showing my friend Nico some of the cool stuff I've got.
Hi.
Good afternoon, señorita. And just what are your intentions toward my son?
Intentions? We were just talking.
How nice. She has good bone structure, Raoul. Has she any brains?
She's a reporter.
Is she? And what sort of questions has she been asking?
I'm a freelance photojournalist. I do lifestyle features.
For what sort of magazines?
It looked safest to play dumb with good bone structure. Haya, Lifestyle of the Super Rich and Vainglorious, Envy Magazine,
Excellent! Raoul, you've chosen well for a change.
It was pretty obvious who pulled the strings around here. I hope George was making good use of the time I was buying him.
And then it goes...
And when you were in this band of yours, you used to play that song for 2 hours?
Yeah, we were really famous at our college. Still, ours wasn't as good as the original version.
I have never heard that song before. Yet I have no doubt that this must be true.
Hey!
Psst!
Hey, George!
Dwayne Henderson! Boy, am I ever glad to see you. Get to the American consul and tell him I've been in prison without charge.
Get real, George. He was the previous occupant of that cell you're in. We're gonna have to use good old American know-how to get you out of there.
Uh-oh.
That, and this truck full of explosives I've got here.
Dwayne, listen to me. You'll kill all of us.
You're such a naysayer, George. It'll go like clockwork. It's positive to positive. You gotta get the bare copper wire here. Let me just, damn. All right, I'll just hook that up. All right, there we go. Okay, just a minute. I've got to get to a safe distance.
Quick, Miguel, hit the mattress.
You have strange customs up north.
Here we go!
Too late.
Are we dead yet?
Horseshit!
What happened to the explosives?
There ain't no explosives. My dumbass supplier must have given me organic fertilizer instead of chemical. All I got here is 400 pounds of lightly fried horse apples.
That's a lovely image, Dwayne. Never mind, I'll think of something.
I couldn't reach the noose.
I can't believe that punk jailed me for no reason at all.
So? It happens.
But I'm a U.S. citizen.
See? That's true. They dare not execute you.
Yeah? Well, that's something.
They'll have to arrange an accident for you instead.
Why is that noose hanging from the bars?
Rinaldo strung it up for me to hang myself. Don't cry for me, Senor Stubborn. When I am dead, the goddess will take my soul to rest in paradise.
Listen to me, Miguel. You give me that rope and I'll get us out of here. Is there somewhere you can hide from the general?
Of course. My friends have a boat ready to take me upriver. But how are you going to break out of here with just a short piece of rope?
I'm not sure, but I'll think of something.
If your plan doesn't work, will you let me hang myself in peace?
Hey, Dwayne, I want you to tie this rope to your truck and then drive forward.
I'd had no idea whether this was really going to work, but I'd seen it in a black and white Western. Of course, Hopalong was using a horse, and Dwayne had a 4-ton truck, but hey, the principle's sound.
Anything you say, George!
Please forgive my mother. She can be a little difficult.
Oh, my feet, Raoul! Propose, you idiot!
Don't mind her. She just wants grandchildren.
Don't think I can't hear you, Raoul. I want a worthy successor, and you're not it. Propose now, or I'll do it for you.
Look, Nico, we haven't known each other very long, but...
What the hell was that?
I didn't know what was going on, but Georges had to be involved in it somehow.
I ain't gonna say a thing, because that sweet sound of falling masonry says it all.
Quick, senor, the river.
Huh? Wait, what about Nico?
Josh, what have you done? You only had to sneak a look at the chart, and it's turned into World War III.
No time to explain. Come on.
Don't move, terrorist scum.
You talking to me, Junior?
Yes, I'm talking to you, fat man. And my name's not Junior.
A word to the wise, Junior. You carry on waving that pea shooter in my face, and the next person who sees it is going to be your proctologist. Savvy?
General, I am happy to report that I have apprehended the terrorist.
Oh, idiot, not them. The other American and the French woman, they're the ones.
Thank you.
When I recovered consciousness, I was alone, washed up on the riverbank. My head was aching fiercely, and my mouth tasted like a swamp. At first, I thought the music I heard was in my head. Just my luck to wind up in paradise with a migraine. But I followed the sound and discovered a treehouse in a nearby clearing. That vine rope could be useful. I placed the bank statement over the damp leaves. As I held the fetish to the iron rim of the wheel, a shower of sparks cascaded onto the leaves.
Men, put out that fire. I caught a sick woman up here.
Sorry, Father, but I needed to attract your attention. My name is Stobart, George Stobart.
I'm Father Hubert. I don't suppose you speak French.
Huh? Why do you want to know that?
I found a young woman with a fever by the river this morning. The poor girl is close to death. And there's nothing I can do for her but pray. I don't understand her, but I think she's speaking French.
Hang on. That must be Nico. That's my girlfriend you've got in your treehouse. What's the matter with her?
She's been bitten by a venomous liver snake.
But can't you do something for her? There's a cure, isn't there?
I ran out of penicillin and morphine years ago. But the local people speak of a root which they believe will counteract the poison.
Where can I find this root?
I don't know. But maybe the shaman at the village can tell us.
Will you show me the way to the village?
Me? Oh, but... I can't.
Can't? Nico's life depends on it.
You're right. Of course I should, despite my own guilt and shame. But I can't go as a representative of God with a creased collar.
A creased collar? You mean you put your personal attire higher than the life of a sick woman?
I will not go to that village looking anything but my best.
Give me your collar. I'm sure I can find a way to press it.
My son. In the meantime, I must contemplate my sermon.
There was obviously more than a creased collar bothering the priest. So there I was, hundreds of miles from civilization, doing the housework for a priest. It's a strange world. The vine provided a drive belt to connect the two stones. It was heavy. I guessed that was intentional. Press worked surprisingly well on the collar. Here's your collar, Father.
Thank you, George. You'd probably think it a little odd of me to make such a fuss.
Oh, no. If I'd been living in the jungle for 11 years, I'd be completely screwy, too.
Screwy? Yes, perhaps I am. Ever since my last visit to that village.
Now you've got your collar back, will you take me to the village?
I've still not finished my sermon.
Look, Father, I still don't know why you're so reluctant to visit that village. And it's none of my business. Whatever the reason, it can't be more important than saving Nico's life.
You're right. I must be crazy. We must make haste if we're to reach the village before nightfall.
By the time we reached the village, it was sunset.
Hello, boys. Glad to see you're still wearing the underpants. What?
They're the best Christmas present we ever had, Father.
Mine are too tight.
Well, we all have our cross to bear. This is George. He has a request to make. I'm afraid I can't stay. Good luck, George.
That's a relief. I never feel comfortable with him about.
Me neither.
These damn pants keep riding right up my butt.
So, what do you want?
My girlfriend has been bitten by a snake.
So? Everyone in my family has been bitten by snakes.
I was bitten by a dormouse once.
She's real sick. I hoped your wise man might have medicine.
Wise man? You must have the wrong village.
Father Hubert said there was a wise man in the village who could help me.
No, there's no one of that description here.
Ooh, he must mean the old man, the shaman.
I thought he just made up all those stories he tells. I never thought of him as being wise.
I'd like to see the shaman, please.
You can't just go walking in there and demand to speak to the shaman.
Why not?
You have to observe the protocol. The shaman demands tribute.
Tribute? You mean, like a gift?
That's right.
The eternal question. What do you give a man who has everything?
Here, he'll like these biscuits.
If you say so.
So, is this your first visit to our planet?
I am from the same planet as you. I'm from California. Why, we're practically neighbors.
He liked the biscuits, especially the black ones. He wants to know if you've any more.
That was...
I put the Mayan stone in the empty box.
Here, I found some more of those biscuits for the shaman.
I'll give them to him.
What do you do for entertainment here in the jungle?
We make documentaries. Me and Tabtik, we've appeared in 7 TV films and an article in National Geographic.
The shaman wants to talk to you.
I hoped he would. Well, it's been nice to talk to you guys.
Please, sit down. Welcome, George.
Thanks.
It has long been foretold that a white man would bring the Coyote Stone to this village.
I don't suppose this would be any use to you.
It sure would. This wax on a stick will change our lives.
What do you want it for?
To decorate our bodies for the monkey dance.
My girlfriend's been bitten by a snake.
And you want me to heal her?
That's the idea. Can you do it?
I'm not sure. My gums aren't what they used to be.
Listen, my girlfriend's in a coma. Please, old man, give me the root.
What root?
Father Hubert told me of a root which could cure the bite of the river snake.
There's nothing sacred with these people. That was our secret, known only to members of my tribe.
If that root is my chance of saving Nico's life, then I want it. Fast.
There is time yet, George Stobart. Time to learn why you were called here.
Fine. If I listen to your story, then will you give me the root?
The eel travels far, but still returns to the place of his spawning.
And look, I'm running a tight schedule, so can you skip the riddles?
Many years ago, when the world was young, the great god and king Quetzalcoatl was defeated by trickery and deceit. His enemy Tezcatlipoca took his place as leader and demanded terrible human sacrifices. A group of loyal priests found a way to trap Tezcatlipoca. But his powers were so great, they knew he would not remain trapped forever. His time of incarceration would end with the eclipse, which marked the close of the fifth age. So the priests fashioned three obsidian stones which contained the power to seal the mirror for all time. But before the stones could be put in place, they were seized by the invading Spanish.
But how did they trap Tez, the evil god?
They built a pyramid which they told Tezcatlipoca was dedicated to him. At its center, they fashioned a huge mirror of perfectly smooth obsidian. Luring him into the pyramid with praise and flattery, they used sorcery to ensnare him in the mirror.
There's an eclipse of the sun due very soon, isn't there?
Correct. The eclipse which marks the ending of the fifth age will come before the next full moon.
Less than 2 weeks.
I didn't really believe that Tezcatlipoca would return, but I figured Karzak's plans were in some way connected.
What happened to the stones?
They were taken by the Spanish to the coastal town that is now called Guaramonte City. Only one stone reached Spain. The other two fell into the hands of buccaneers. The Jaguar Stone was captured by an English captain, El Draco. The Eagle Stone was taken by a pirate called Ketch. The third stone, the Coyote Stone, reached Spain safely. That is the stone in your possession.
Tell me more about the Jaguar Stone.
Many centuries ago, the port of Guaramonte was entered by a ship flying Spanish colors. The captain, the man known as El Draco, sent soldiers ashore. Only when the soldiers arrested the mayor did the people realize that they were English privateers. The mayor was held hostage while the soldiers looted and plundered the city. Amongst the treasures they stole was the Jaguar Stone.
Where is the Jaguar Stone now?
I suppose El Draco took it back to his homeland, across the Great Sea.
To England? Tell me more about the Eagle Stone.
The stone was loaded onto a galleon with many valuable artifacts plundered by the Spanish. But shortly after leaving harbor, a terrible squall blew up and damaged the ship. The ship was intercepted by a bloodthirsty pirate, Captain Ketch. Ketch made short work of overpowering the crew, stealing the treasure, and sinking the Spanish ship.
Where's the Eagle Stone now?
Nobody knows for sure. Ketch retired from piracy and bought an island in the Caribbean.
What do I do when I find the stones?
Bring them here to me and I shall prepare you. The stones must be taken to the heart of the pyramid. Only there can they be used to seal the gate by which Tezcatlipoca will return to this world.
Now do I get the root?
Here, take it. Make haste if you wish to save the girl's life. The hummingbird sings to me of death to come.
Now you're talking in riddles again. Listen, is it okay if I crash here? I've got no chance of finding my way through the jungle in the dark.
You're welcome, but you probably won't get much sleep
Tonight's the night of the monkey dance.
I left the village at dawn and stumbled back through the jungle in a post-party daze. It was just like sneaking back to my parents' house when I was younger. Except Oakland didn't have monkeys or parrots. The cone was ideal as a makeshift container. Drink this.
Oh, George, it's horrible.
Just swallow it down. Okay, try and rest now, darling. You'll need all your strength when we go after the other two stones.
Other stones?
What other stones? What have you gotten me into now, George Tobart?
The patient is sounding more like her old self already.
Nico recovered quickly from her fever. To save time, we decided to split up and look for each stone independently. I traced the pirate Ketch to a remote island in the Caribbean. With the fortune he'd amassed from piracy, he'd retired to a place that was later called Ketch's Landing.
My name's George Stobart.
Good afternoon, Mr. Stobart. Would you care for tea?
No, thank you, ma'am. I don't like tea. Can you tell me anything about Captain Ketch?
More than you can tell me about your great-great-great-great-grandfather, no doubt.
You're his descendants?
Certainly. Captain Ketch was born in Dorset, England, in the reign of King Henry VIII. His family were undistinguished farmers, but young Frederick Ketch decided to go to sea.
We have plenty of seamen in our family, Mr. Stobart.
Are you interested in history, Mr. Stobart?
Yes, I am. You were telling me about Captain Ketch. Do go on.
Oh, yes. He sailed under Hawkins.
Jim Hawkins?
John Hawkins. One of the great traders of the Elizabethan age. In 1568, Frederick Ketch was a young man serving aboard the Jesus, Hawkins' flagship. They sailed from England to Africa and across the wide Atlantic to these islands. Ketch was never to see the shores of England again.
How come Ketch never made it home?
Because the Spaniards sank the Jesus in an act of treachery.
You said Hawkins' fleet traded between Africa and the Indies. What was it they were trading?
Black men with no shirts.
You have to understand, Mr. Stobart, that this was the 16th century.
That doesn't alter the fact that Hawkins and Ketch were slavers and pirates.
Would it surprise you to learn that Hawkins was also a devoutly religious man?
He transported slaves in a ship named after Jesus Christ. In my book, that makes him a hypocrite. What happened to Ketch? Was he killed?
Oh, no. He got away and returned to this island, to this very house.
The Frederick Ketch Memorial Museum.
It's a museum? That could be just what I'm looking for. Is it true Frederick Ketch was a pirate?
Frederick Ketch was emphatically not a pirate.
They hanged him, you know, down there on the beach in front of his family. Didn't bother with the trial, just whipped him out from his breakfast table and hoisted him up in chains.
Well, if he wasn't a pirate, what did they hang him for?
Envy. Pure green-eyed envy. He had been a successful privateer, you see, and had accumulated great wealth.
As rich as a mink in a paddock.
Shut up, Mina.
Yes, Frost.
The small-minded governor and his lackeys wanted his money. Trumped up some ridiculous charge about breaking the conditions of his letter of marque. And hanged him like a common thief. The blackguards!
Letter of marque?
The document that permitted him to engage and destroy the enemies of the crown. The difference between a lawful privateer and a pirate. Yoo-hoo!
Sorry, Frost.
Well, why didn't Ketch just say, take a hike, guys, I've got a pirating license?
Frederick Ketch was not a pirate!
But he did show them his letter of marque.
But they destroyed it and hanged him anyway.
It was locked.
The house is closed.
How come?
It is undergoing refurbishment.
Refurbishment? Where are the workmen?
Preparation is half the work, young man. The intention is to prepare the museum for the new century.
The Frederick Ketch Memorial Museum. It would look nice in neon.
A museum for a pirate?
There was a stony silence.
I have already told you, sir, he was not a pirate. It's precisely this sort of vile misrepresentation that Mr. Bronson is seeking to rebalance.
Oh? How?
Mr. Bronson has kindly agreed to undertake the museum's refurbishment at a very reasonable price. He understands the importance of a sense of history.
He also understands spherical geometry.
Mina?
Well, he does.
Listen, ma'am, I came a long way to visit this place.
If we make an exception in your case, everyone will want to get in.
Pardon me, but I didn't exactly have to fight my way through the crowds.
You're the second visitor we've had today.
No, I'm sorry, but it's impossible.
The ladder extended easily.
Hi, Puss. Wanna play? Hey, Cat. Watch where you're putting those claws.
Hi, is this Ketch's Landing?
Yeah, man. You wanna buy some fish?
Nah, I don't like fish. What's your name?
Rio. It means river. What about you?
George. It means, it's just a name. How come the old ladies closed the museum?
It's Bronson stolen.
The guy with her theodolite?
He made the plans for redeveloping the museum. They kinda regret it, you know. The man's a crook.
Do you know anything about pirate treasure?
Man, that's all stories. There's no such thing as a real pirate treasure.
No school today?
No, sir.
What about your education?
I can fish, sail, and swim. I've been looking after myself since I was 6, and I'm bilingual.
Aren't you a little overqualified for a beach bum?
Well, you know, there's a lot of competition.
What do you know about Captain Ketch?
Just what everybody knows around here. He was a pirate and get himself hung.
Do you know anything about a forthcoming eclipse?
No, but that explains why the weather's about to get real bad.
Rio, it's a beautiful day. There's no more than a whisker of cloud in the sky.
Trust the man, it's going to get real bad.
couldn't get to... I just had to sneak a look at those plans.
Hey, get out of there.
You know, wherever I go, I hear those words. Paris, Syria, Ireland, or Spain. Makes no difference.
What do you think you're doing?
I was trying to show some interest in your project. I just had to sneak a
Get out of there.
Okay. I've been talking to Rio, the little fisher boy.
I'll thank you not to mention that little wretch in my presence.
Dirty little whelk. Nasty fishy boy.
That will do, Mina.
I gather you don't have much time for the little boy.
That child is a delinquent, Mr. Stobart.
Yeah, well, he's only, what, 11, maybe?
A knave with one hand on the tops.
What is it about Rio that you don't like, Miss Frost?
Well, once upon a time, he and Emily...
Be quiet this instant, Mina.
What can you tell me about Emily?
Emily, what business can she be of yours?
Her parents were killed in a typhoon.
We, as her only living relatives, took it upon ourselves to raise the child.
It's good to know Charity isn't dead.
Oh, but she is. Washed overboard in the typhoon.
Mr. Stobart wasn't talking about Emily's mother. He was being sarcastic.
What else can you tell me about Emily?
How dare you pry into our family in this way? I refuse to answer any more of your impertinent questions.
Tell me about your friend Emily.
Why are you so interested in Emily Ketch?
Emily Ketch? A descendant of Captain Ketch, the pirate?
Yeah.
Well, it doesn't bother you?
Why should it? We're all responsible for our ancestors.
Will you help me get those plans?
I don't want to go nowhere near that man. He promised to draw me when he found the fish I left in his sleeping bag.
Is that your cat?
Yes, it is.
It's Ruddles.
Do you like cats, Mr. Stobart?
You bet. Especially spit roast. You're really fond of that cat, aren't you?
He is our companion and our solace.
I thought about catnapping the little monster until they let me in, but it wasn't my style. Maybe there was some other way I could use their affection for the cat to get me into the house. Okay. It was time for diversionary tactics. I thought I saw a little girl down on the beach.
You must be mistaken.
He must be mistaken. Mustn't he, Frost?
I'm sure I'm not. A little girl and that young fisher boy.
What? It's not possible. What were they doing?
Are the kinds of things that all little boys and girls get up to at their age?
When I was a little girl, we used to play cows and milkmaids.
Woe betide you if you're lying to us, Mr. Stobart. Heaven help you!
With a creak of ancient corsetry, the sisters sailed majestically over the distant horizon. I wasn't going to risk further laceration.
Sisters come by here.
Did I? They look madder than usual, so I hide until they gone by.
Just as well. They thought you were playing with Emily. Boy, were they steamed.
Emily? You're madder than them.
Can you let me have a fish, kid?
I thought you say you don't like fish.
It's not for me. It's a present.
For the old ladies? Well, it makes a change from flowers and candy.
No, it's for their cat.
Okay. What do I get out of it?
I can pay you. I've got Quaramontian dollars, French francs, and traveler's checks.
You must be joking. The nearest bank is 3 islands away.
Will you give me a fish if I give you are these ugly, tasteless nylon panties worth a fish?
No, ma'am.
Is this worm worth a fish?
Could be good bait. How did it die?
I think it drowned in tequila.
Just like my Uncle Gabriel. Yeah, I'll have that. Okay, I'll get you a fish. It might take a while, though.
There was nothing else I wanted to ask the boy. I didn't know the first thing about sailing a dinghy. It was a seaworthy little craft, in bad need of a coat of paint, but spotlessly clean and maintained. No luck with the fish?
No, man. They don't want bite. That's cause they know there's a storm brewing.
Storm? Well, I don't think so.
Hey! I caught a bite!
You have?
It's a big one! A real big one!
Reel him in, Rio. Jeez, it must be a whale or something.
Rustiest whale I ever see.
I still need a fish, Rio.
Okay, make me try again.
Maybe you better change your bait.
The only serviceable part of the bicycle's wreck was a rubber inner tube. You just never know when you're gonna need stuff like that.
There's a fish.
I can't put it in my pocket while it's flapping about like that.
No problem.
That should get the old cat dancing. I just hoped it didn't give itself a cardiac. I put my lucky lump of coal in the catapult, took aim.
No!
My lucky piece of coal vanished into the distance. It looked like it was going into orbit. I put the ball in the catapult, took aim.
Yes!
Okay, so it was a lucky shot, but I knocked the off my target. Clean off the end of the flagpole.
I'll have to put the spare target on the other flagpole. A whole morning's work wasted. I'm gonna fix all this, and then I'm gonna fix you, you hear?
Yeah? Fine. I'll be waiting.
What you doing, Bronson? Just hanging around?
I'm gonna kill you for this, Stobart! Get me down from here!
What, so you can kill me? Gee, you talked me out of it, Bronson.
I felt a little guilty about leading Bronson up there, but not much, obviously. The marker was a bright, shiny thing, and I have a weakness for bright, shiny things. It wasn't gonna be much use without the theodolite, though. With Bronson out of the way, I could finally get a clear look at the plans. Engineers' drawings didn't mean much to me, but one thing was clear. These plans were for a 5-story, 200-roomed, luxury, pirate-themed hotel. Another stain on the bedspread of paradise.
He climbed up there of his own accord.
Then help him, you stupid man! Quickly, before he falls!
Here.
Bronson's plans.
This means nothing to me.
She's not wearing her reading glasses.
Ah, wait. Yes, I see now. I see it all too clearly. That man is planning to build a huge hotel. Bronson is a confidence trickster. Mina, we have been duped. I'm glad we didn't sign his contract.
Oh, I hate tricksters, especially confident ones.
Come, Mina. Persona non grata.
Yes. Come here, Keenum.
Kindly disentangle yourself from our flagpole and eject yourself from our property this very minute.
Disentangle. Eject.
Hey, cut that out, you crazy old bat.
How dare you? Mina isn't crazy. She's just engagingly eccentric.
Yeah, as a bedbug.
Ouch!
Lovely as this little vista is, I'd be really grateful if you could let me into the museum now.
Certainly, young man. We are most grateful to you for exposing this scoundrel, Mina, the lock.
Thanks, ladies.
Stobart, be a pal. Get these harpies off me.
Ooh.
While George was basking in the sun-drenched Caribbean, I went to London. It was a long shot, but I thought I'd start my search for the Jaguar Stone at the British Museum. Polished obsidian. Nothing like the one I was looking for. According to the caption, this was the scrying mirror given to Dr. John Dee by Sir Francis Drake. The cabinet was locked. The cabinet contained a dagger decorated with Mayan designs. It was a stone identical in size and style to the Coyote Stone. However, this stone bore the image of a jaguar. It was an obsidian stone.